game like today kind of epitomize your plan to save Godley for Sunday? Is this kind of a reason behind it?
Well, no. I'm going to stick with that plan. I Bobby Wall was good. He wasn't great. He was good. And I don't want to take anything away from him. The guy just threw a four-hit shutout, I think it was. Three-hit shutout. His defense didn't help him a lot. And again, I'm not taking anything away from Ole Miss. But I'm a little confused on the lack of energy, of the urgency. We have a chance to come out and beat a good team on a Friday night, which we haven't done very often, to win a series, and it starts with Friday. Doesn't take it away that we can't win the series, but we just had no energy, and I'll take some blame for that. I'm the head coach, but I don't know if I'm the guy that has to get them motivated to play this sport and to put on the uniform and have a lot of pride to play. And we kind of resorted back to earlier in the year when we were kind of passive and tentative and kind of wondering what was going to happen. And that's what's disappointing is, like I said to them, we can't win enough to ever get bored with winning. And I believe that. And I've fortunately, throughout a lot of my career, I've won, and it doesn't get boring. You don't want to come out on the short end, and you have to, but you have to do things to make that from happen, to create that or keep that from happening.
That lack of energy, what do you credit that to? Because those back-to-back innings with the play at the plate, preserving, you know, what could have been some runs there, and that, it seems like energizing play.
Well, and I think Bobby Wall had something to do with that because that created some momentum. Defense creates momentum. Then he went out and shut us down. But I don't know if, and again, I'm not taking anything away from Bobby because I think he's one of the best pitchers in the SEC at the top of it. But we didn't make him pay for anything. When he got behind in the count, we didn't have the success that we've been doing against the normal Friday night guys here in the SEC, and we just didn't make him pay for enough. I don't think we pitched well enough, and I don't think we played very good defense in the outfield. And I think that all those things combined with not taking good at-bats leads you to a 5-0 loss.
Maybe not the best at-bats, and then Ole Miss kind of hand-in-hand with three errors, I believe, in the field. Are you going to say anything to address that tomorrow, or what's the plan?
I just told them tomorrow that my expectation is they show up with mentality. And I think we're too far in the season for them to be challenged by their coach to show up with mentality. I mean, just putting on the uniform should get you pretty excited. I know when I squeeze into my uniform, I get pretty excited to be part of this program and try to succeed. So there's no reason why they shouldn't, at their young age, with the energy they should have.
Coach, only 5 runs, but 14 hits. Do you kind of view that number as alarming or more of, say, damage control?
No, I don't think they were great tonight, but the F Troop on a Friday night, you know, kept us in the game. They scored one late on the home run on the elevated changeup, but, you know, they got their hits. They swung the bat. They made us pay for some pitches. I don't look at that as alarming. I mean, it could be 5 runs on 5 hits, and it's the same result. We didn't come out on top, and that's the bottom line in my mind.
Aaron Coolen gave up 8. What were your thoughts on his performance?
Again, I kind of, you know, Aaron went out, and again, you're talking about a young man who, as a freshman, is going out on a Friday night and competing against some of the best pitchers in the SEC. In my opinion, I know of that should get you really excited. That should really jack you up to want to go out and beat one of the best. And I just feel, like I said to Aaron, and I'll say it to everybody, is that when things are going pretty good with Aaron, he pretty much rocks and rolls. But when things go a little sideways, he kind of gives in a little bit. And that's the part he's got to get over. And I keep repeating myself a lot. And those are the things 36 games into the season that we shouldn't have to keep repeating, that these guys start realizing where their success is coming from and where their failures are coming from.
Thanks, guys.